Hey everyone, welcome to the channel. In today's video, we're diving into the all-new iPhone 16 and iPhone 16 Pro, but more specifically, we'll be focusing on their updated cooling systems, and trust me, this is something Apple fans have been waiting for. It seems like Apple has finally realized that no matter how powerful their chips are, if they want to take mobile gaming to the next level, they need to implement modern cooling solutions. Something flagship Android phones have been doing for years with heat pipes, vapor chambers, and even phase change materials. Apple has had its fair share of overheating issues, especially with the iPhone 15. It started with heat problems during charging and persisted intermittently over the device's life cycle. A big part of the issue has been Apple's lack of an effective way to transfer the heat generated by its chips to the device's outer casing. While the iPhone 15 performed well for most users, the rising demands on smartphones mean that this issue needed addressing, and Apple knew it. Now, the cooling solution differs between the iPhone 16 and the iPhone 16 Pro, and here's where things get interesting. For the iPhone 16, Apple has improved thermal dissipation by incorporating graphite within the device. They've also redesigned the internal layout, concentrating heat only in specific areas. This results in a significant improvement in sustained performance. Apple claims up to 30% better sustained performance, which is especially important for heavy gaming. Since iOS is one of the few operating systems that supports 120 FPS for games like Genshin Impact, this upgrade is a big deal for mobile gamers. As for the iPhone 16 Pro, Apple took things a step further. It's built using 100% recycled aluminum, bonded to a titanium frame using something called solid-state diffusion. This technique helps heat flow from the main board to the chassis and out to the titanium frame as efficiently as possible. On top of that, Apple included a graphite-clad aluminum substructure, which conducts heat even better from the chips to the body. According to Apple, these improvements result in a 20% increase in sustained performance, meaning less thermal throttling and a smoother overall experience. I'm surprised Apple have not implemented proven solutions from other manufacturers like a vapor chamber. And I'm really curious to see how these new cooling systems affect thermal throttling and whether the gaming experience will truly be improved on the new iPhones. What do you think? Let me know in the comments below. And don't forget to like this video and subscribe to the channel if you want more content on gaming phones and tech. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.